Today, around 1 year ago, a geologic natural disaster struck Canada, as at 11 p.m. local time on July 30th, 2024, a major landslide occurred 20 kilometers east-southeast of Hansville, resulting in the complete damming of the major Chilcotin River. It would only be a matter of time before this landslide dam burst, resulting in major flooding downstream, which at one point was thought of having the potential in a worst-case scenario to affect 20,000 people. Thankfully, the resulting disaster was far less severe, but nevertheless became the best case study example of a major landslide resulting in a flood of the 21st century. This is the story of what exactly happened, the damage it caused, and its effects in hindsight 1 year later. While not exactly well communicated in my opinion, the specific hillside in question had been known as a slow, large-moving landslide for multiple years. But the indigenous communities have known for longer that this area has produced fairly frequent landslides, calling the region Nagwintled, which roughly translates to landslides across the river. You can see the scarps from several of these undated older landslides nearby. Regardless, on July 30th of 2024 at 11 p.m., a portion of the affected hillside passed a breaking point and could no longer hold up adjacent rock, causing a 380-meter-wide and 880-meter-long swath of the hillside to collapse to the north at a speed exceeding 30 kilometers per hour. A man and his dog escaped this disaster who were camping nearby. However, as soon as this landslide ceased its motion, the fact that it had climbed as much as 43 meters or 141 feet up the Chilcotin River's north side resulted in the complete damming of this major river. Thus, to the west upstream of this 9.3 million cubic meter landslide, water began accumulating in an ever-growing lake at a rate of more than 150 cubic meters per second. This lake grew quickly, soon climbing to more than 30 meters or 98.4 feet deeper than the normal depth of the Chilcotin River and extending a whopping 12 kilometers upstream. Even the edge of this one particular hill was inundated by floodwaters despite being 26 meters or 85.3 feet above the Chilcotin River's normal level. The trees, vegetation, and sediment which were inundated were added to the lake, eventually involving 70 million cubic meters of material. Then, after many nearby areas both upstream and downstream of the dam had been evacuated, the lake cut through a portion at the end of the landslide dam at 9:50 a.m. local time on August 5th. What started as a trickle soon cascaded into a turbulent flood as the dam breach rapidly widened, causing a wall of water 50 feet higher than the normal river level to race downstream at high speeds. As the flood continued downstream, it completely removed an entire island forever in the middle of the river. Soon after, the floodwaters reached a series of structures and homes 5 miles to the east of the initial landslide site, inundating and washing away goods and 3 entire structures. In parts, the entire river pathway completely changed, moving as much as 100 to 300 meters north or south from its prior location. This occurred in part due to the immense amount of sediment contained within. Another 5 miles downstream, a series of 3 cabins were reached and washed away as water climbed a full 9 meters above the normal levels. Thankfully, as the distance from the landslide site increased, the height of floodwaters decreased, meaning that at the intersection with Big Barn Creek, another 84 kilometers downriver, floodwaters only rose 3.5 meters above their normal levels. While such small flood heights did not cause any additional damage, it carried with it substantial amounts of sediment and debris, of which 30,000 cubic meters was caught in a trap southwest of the town of Hope. The floodwaters eventually reached the Salish Sea on August 9, 2024. Despite a dozen structures being washed away and more than $1 million in damage having occurred, the disaster could have been so much worse if a much more catastrophic and rapid breach of the landslide dam had occurred. Yet, even today, some of the area impacted by the greatest depth of floodwaters is still unstable, as since the floodwaters carved new paths for the Chilcotin River, it created new, steep, and unstable slopes prone to smaller-scale landslides which did not previously exist. This is why, in some locations, the scar created by the disaster is 50 feet higher than the floodwaters ever reached, as this represents the top of a series of minor landslides that struck. Today, the public is more aware of the potential for landslides to occur in riverbeds and the effects they might have.